Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Ritchie, and I want to thank you for joining me today. The idea I have this time around is I hope that what we're going to do over the next few months is a series of talks where we can talk about cataract surgery. We have had a tremendous number of advancements in the treatment of cataracts, that is, cataract surgery, that are ideas and concepts that can be a little difficult to get a handle on. So I want to spend a little time going over that. First, we're going to talk about how do you know when you should have your cataract removed. Then we'll do a series of segments over the next few months on what are the options with cataract surgery. I have a lot of patients who say, well, what should I do? And tell me what to do and what's best for me. And I'll go over all that because the simple answer is it really depends on what you want. So when we talk about cataract surgery here at the Ritchie Eye Clinic, I turn the question around and say, where do you want to be when we're done? So let's start first by talking about what's a cataract and when should you have it removed. So if we start by looking at the model of the eye, the front portion of the eye is called the cornea. When you look at the eye, you see the colored part of the eye, but that's actually inside the eye, and that portion is called the iris. Now, everybody knows about the black spot in your eye. That's the pupil, but the pupil is nothing more than a hole in the iris that allows you to see. So the cornea, the iris, and the hole in the iris called the pupil are at the very front of the eye. If we then rotate the eye and look just a little bit behind the iris, we see the lens in the eye. Then we have this great space between the back of the lens and the back of the eye. This is the space where we have a jelly substance called vitreous, and lining the inside of the back of the eye is the nerve layer called the retina. Now the way the eye works is really very simple, and now I'm going to switch to some other pictures to show you this. Looking at a photograph of the eye now, or a schematic, here's the cornea, the iris, the lens, the vitreous cavity, and then the retina is the nerve layer lining the inside of the back of the eye. This portion of the retina is called the macula, and it's where we see fine detail. Light enters the eye, passing through the cornea, through the lens, to focus on the retina. Assuming your retina is normal, anything that interferes with light passing into the eye will blur your vision. Well, the lens in the eye turns yellow over time, no different than hair turning gray. In fact, you could argue it starts turning yellow when we're 20. It's yellowed enough by the time we're 40 that we start to lose our ability to see up close and we need a bifocal or a pair of readers. And by the time we're 60 to 80, the yellowed lens is now interfering with many aspects of our daily life. But if you think of the eye as an automobile, this is the engine. This is like a dirty windshield. A dirty windshield will, under no circumstances, damage the engine. When do you clean the dirty windshield? You clean the windshield when it bothers you. So, when should your cataract be removed? It should be removed when you say to me, I don't like my vision. I have glare at night. I struggle with the television. My reading's not as good as it was. I need more light to read. I'm just not happy with it. Whatever reason you find, if you're not happy with your vision and the cataract is the problem, we can fix it. Now, fixing it does require a surgery. And if we look at our little chart here, with cataract surgery, we make a very tiny incision in the eye, we use a little handheld vacuum cleaner, we break the cataract into little pieces and vacuum it out of the eye. But this is actually a much better picture to help you understand that we're going to get rid of the cataract. We're going to carefully leave behind the outer shell of the cataract called the capsule. Why would we leave behind the capsule? We do it because the capsule is attached in the eye and it's going to form a nice little pocket or a pouch. And we're going to use that to support and hold the new lens. So what we're really doing with cataract surgery is we're going to replace that yellowed lens with a clear plastic one in exactly the same spot. Now you can see better. So in review, a cataract is the lens in the eye simply turning yellow. It's no different than hair going gray. Happens to everybody. It's not a disease. Anybody over 40, you have a cataract. It's just a question of how bad is it. When it's bad enough that it interferes with your vision or you're not happy with the way you see, we can fix it. That is how you decide when to have cataract surgery. In the upcoming months, what I'll talk about next is how do you decide what type of cataract surgery to have with all the options available. Thanks again for joining me.